In this tutorial, you will learn how you can create a round robin in make.com so that you can, for example, evenly distribute leads between team members. And I'm going to use this scenario over here to explain how that works. You can also use a round robin in make for different things, but I think this is quite a good example to get to understand how the round robin works. It's not super straightforward, but it's not super difficult either. So first we have a method where our leads are coming in. So in my case, it's a Google Sheet, but you can maybe also connect it with your card provider. Maybe you have a web where the data is coming from. We have some kind of way where the leads are coming from. So I use this Google Sheet over here. And then basically what we want to do is that the scenario starts, we have a new lead, and then we want to go into our router, which in this case has three different routes, three different options. And then each time we want to send it to one of the team members. But we do not want to do that randomly. We want to send it to them one by one. So the first time we have a new lead, we want to send the info to Ben. The second time we have a new lead, we want to send the info to John. The third time we have a new lead, we want to send the info to Vera. The fourth time we have a lead, we want to send the info to Ben, and then to John, and then to Vera, then to Ben, then to John, then to Vera, and so on and so on. We just want to send it to them one by one. Now, what we're going to use for that is the increment function. The increment function is a built-in tool which gives you a number, and every time the scenario runs, the number is going to be one higher than the previous time. Let me quickly demonstrate that. We just say here, run this module only. Then you see now, this is the first time the scenario runs. So the value of the increment function is 1. We run it again. Now the value is 2. We run it again. The value is 3. Now, and so on and so on. This can really go on for 10,000, 100,000 of times. Just every time it will increase the number by 1. But this is really important because we're going to use this number, the value of the increment function, in the filter of our routes. So as you can see over here, we have a route with a filter, and then this is our condition of the filter. Over here we have a formula where we calculate. Over here we have the increment function, a value. Then we use the modulo math operator, which you can find over here. And the modulo is a little bit techy. I also had to look it up, I have to admit, but that basically calculates the remainder of the value of the increment function divided by this number over here. And this number over here is for the amount of routes you have in your router, which in this case is our round robin. So basically what we do is we have the value over here, we divide it by 3, and then the modulo will calculate the remainder, and the remainder is always going to be 0, 1, or 2. So here you also see an example. If we have 8, so let's say this is the increment function, right, and the value is 8, and then we have modulo 3, then 3 fits 2 whole times in 8, and the remainder is going to be 2. Then 17 modulo 3, then we can also calculate, okay, 3, how many times does this fit in 17? I think 5 times, right? 5 times 3 is 15. And then we have 17 minus 15 is 2. Now, then also 22 modulus 3. So then here 3, we calculate, then we have 1 left. Now, you do not really have to know how that works, just this is the formula that you need. So we have here the increment function, modulo, and then the amount of routes in your router. And then we have here, under the numeric operators, we say equal to, and then the first route has to be 0, the second route has to be 1, and then the third round has to be 2. Now, let's test this, how that works. So we say run once, we get a new lead, so we have our new lead over here, then the increment function value now is 4, and then you see over here, it went over here to round robin option 2. Then we can also look up here what happened. And then you see here that we have 4 modulo 3. So 3 fits 1 time in 4, and then the remainder of that is 1. So that's why it went over here, and then we sent the lead info to John. Now let's run this again. So we get the lead info. You see now that we have 5. Then we went to round robin option 3. And then we have here 5, right? You can see that 5 modulo 3. And then now 3 fits like 1 time basically in 5, right? And then the remainder of that is 2. And that's why I went over here. Now, then we do it again. And then you see now that the increment function value is 6. We go over here, you see 6 modulo 3 is 0. Because if we divide 6 by 3, then we have exactly 2 and we have nothing left anymore. So that's why we have here 0 over here. So yeah, every time the scenario runs, it will just go to the next person, to the next person, to the next person because of the increment function and then the condition in our filter of the route. And you can, in this case, we use like 3 round robin options, right? But if you want, you can also use maybe 5. And it works exactly the same. So we have our increment function. This will give us a number. We go into the router and then we calculate here the increment function value, modulo, and then what is important is that you change the number 3 to 5, because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 options in our router. And then also here, numeric operator equal to 0, to 1, to 2, to 3, to 4. So let me also demonstrate this, and you can see that that works. So we run over here, and then you see it went over here. So here we have 1, modulo 5. The remainder is 1. We can run it again. Then it goes to round robin option 3. Round robin option, I should have changed this to 4. And then it goes to round robin option 5. And if you want, you can also use this for a cool A/B testing in make.com. So if you want to learn how that works, then check out this tutorial over here. It's, for example, really useful if you send out marketing emails to leads automatically and you want to figure out what the best one is.